This is clickbait. Seriously, it's clickbait. Don't watch this video. I have so many other videos you can watch, so check them out instead. This video is for a specific set of people, not the top 1%. This is actually for average, regular people. So if you're smart, you do not need this video. Thank you for watching, but this video is not for you. Now that that's out of the way, why would I say you shouldn't learn to code in 2025 when I have coding courses on even LinkedIn Learning, programming books like Simplified JavaScript for Very Important Programmers and Git Prodigy, when I have a platform Nextjob.org that helps you in applying to programming roles? It's because something fundamental has changed and almost nobody is talking about it. You see, the way we've been teaching coding, the way we've been learning coding, it's from a different era, an era where knowing how to write code was enough, an era where memorizing syntax made you valuable. But in 2025, that era is gone. And if you're learning to code the traditional way, you're learning to become obsolete. Let that sink in for a moment before you start attacking me in the comments, you smart people who I begged not to watch this video. Back to the regular people. You're probably thinking, but everyone says learning to code is the future. And they're right. But they're also wrong. Let me explain. Open up ChatGPT right now and ask it to write you a function. Any function. A certain algorithm, data validation, API endpoints. Watch what happens. Perfect code every time, or almost every time, but better than what most developers write, faster than any human can type. This means something profound. If AI can write better code than most developers, what's the point of calling yourself a programmer, a coder? We need to think bigger. See, learning to code is still important. You need to understand how code works. You need to know what's possible. But that's just the beginning. It's become only a foundation and should no longer be your destination. You know why? Ask that same AI to build you a real system, something that handles actual user data, something that needs to scale, something that has integrations, interconnected parts, and that cannot afford to break. And watch what happens. Now it struggles because writing code and building systems are two completely different things. And this is where humans shine. This is where you can shine. When you're building real systems, you're not just writing code, you're solving problems, real problems. Let me give you an example. Say you're building a simple form, a contact form. Seems straightforward, right? But wait, what happens when someone enters invalid data? What happens when they try to submit the form twice? What happens when your server is down or when it's slow? These are not coding problems. These are thinking problems, and this is just a simple form. Now, imagine you're building something bigger, maybe a payment system, a user authentication system, or even a data processing pipeline. At that point, the code is the easy part. The hard part is everything else. Understanding what could go wrong, planning for edge cases, designing for scale, getting users on board, and understanding their pain points. These are the skills that matter in this new era of development. But here's what most people do instead. They watch tutorial after tutorial. They memorize syntax. They keep building clones. You know, they copy paste code and they think they're learning to be developers. They're not. They're learning to be code writers. And in this new era of development, code writers are becoming obsolete. But developers, real developers, they're more valuable than ever because they know how to think about systems. They know how to solve real problems. They know how to do things that work, not just things that run. So what should you do? First, stop trying to memorize code. Just stop it. No one cares anymore. Stop watching tutorials that only teach you syntax. Stop building clones that you never use. Instead, start building things you need. Real things. Useful things. It doesn't matter if they're small. It doesn't matter if they're simple. What matters is that they solve real problems. Your problems. Because when you build something you actually need, something changes. You start thinking differently. You start asking better questions. Not, how do I write this function? But why don't I add this feature? How can I make this easier to use? What if I need to change this later? These are the questions that matter. These are the questions that make you grow. This is the perspective that AI doesn't have. And here's another thing. When you're building something real, you encounter real problems, not tutorial problems, not textbook problems. Real, messy, complicated problems. And that's exactly what you need. Because solving real problems is how you learn to think like a developer. So what I want you to do is this. Think about something you need, something that would make your life easier. It could be simple, doesn't matter what it is. What matters is that it's real, that it's useful, that it's yours. Then start building it. You can use AI tools if you like. Use ChatGPT or Copilot, whatever you need. Let them help you how they can. But you focus on the bigger picture. How should it work? How could it break? How will it grow? Because that's what development is really about. Not writing perfect code, but building useful systems. And in this new era of development, this is what matters. The smart people, they don't want you to know. The top 1% want things to stay exactly as they are. But what I've shared here is what you need right now. This is what will make you valuable. So, no. Don't learn to code in 2025. Learn to build instead. And I'm not saying this because I want you to check out NextJob, the platform I built to help you improve your job search, get interview prep, and generate custom cover letters. I'm even working on a CV generation feature right now. Okay, NextJob is totally unrelated. I just wanted to plug that in. But if this helped you think differently about coding, hit that like button and let me know in the comments, what's the first real thing you're going to build? See you in the next one.